Hello students, today again we are going to start with your one more new lesson. In the previous class we have studied with your chapter 6 and the name of the chapter was How Plants Make Food. Today we will start with your chapter 7 and the name of the chapter is Adaptation in Plants. What do you mean by the word adaptation? What does the word adaptation mean? Adaptation means the process or action of adapting or being adapted. That is, adapted is to adjust to that condition where the plant is. Okay, so the plant, it tries to adjust to the surrounding where it is living. So adaptation in plant, it means adaptations, these are some special features that allow a plant or animal to live in a particular place or habitat. And these adaptations might make it very difficult for the plants to survive in different places. So it explains why certain plants, they are found in one area but not in another. That's what adaptation means. That is how it adjusts with its certain features and survive in that area. Okay, before we start with the lesson, first just fill up this puzzle. Here you will have to do is identify the plants shown below and fill the missing letters. Already there hints also are given. Few alphabets are given and in the blank you have to fill it up. I have filled the first one, that is this first plant is cactus. Okay, so C-A-C-T-U-S. Similarly, you'll have to do for the rest too. You see the picture and then you identify and write it down. Okay, plants are found almost everywhere on the earth. What are the places or the areas where they are found? They are found on the plains, mountains, deserts, lakes and rivers, and even in oceans. So they are found in different places. What are the places? Plains, mountains, deserts, lakes, rivers and oceans. Okay, and the place where a plant or any organism is found naturally is called its habitat. Okay, what is the habitat? It's the natural home. Okay, or the environment for a plant or other organism to survive there. That is habitat. Weather, soil and other conditions in different habitats are different. So all the habitats are not same. Alright, each habitats are different in the conditions of weather, soil. Okay, they are different from each other. They are not same. Plants that develop certain special features to survive in those condition, and this is known as adaptation. Those features which help them to adjust to that surrounding or that area is known as adaptation. Hence, plants found in different habitats are often different from one another. So the plants also differ based on their habitats. Like for a cactus, to survive a cactus to survive, it survives in a desert. It cannot survive in a plain area. Alright, like our aquatic area. Alright, so it needs desert. And this, it is quite different. Cactus adaptation is quite different from pine. Pine, it exists in mountains. Mountain regions are a bit cold. Okay, so pine trees, they survive there. So, different plants, they have different habitat and they differ from each other. Now, let us learn more about adaptation in plants. There are different types of habitat. Okay, the types of habitats are forest, grassland, desert, mountain, polar regions, aquatic habitat. Okay, so these are the different types of habitat. First, before we go, we'll start with terrestrial plants. What are the habitats they are found in? First of all, what are the terrestrial plants? And based on habitats, plants are divided into two groups. They are the terrestrial plants and aquatic plants based on the habitat. Okay, we'll start with our terrestrial plants. What are terrestrial plants? Those plants that grow on land, they are known as the terrestrial plants. So plants which grow on land are known as terrestrial plants. Some terrestrial plants, they grow in the plains, while some grow in the mountains where the climate is cold. Okay, mountain areas is cold, and some grow in deserts, some grow in marshy areas, some grow in heavy rainfall areas. Marshy areas, what's a marshy area? It's an area of land where water covers the ground for a longer period of time. That means in such area the water remains there for a longer period of time. That's a marshy area. So these are the different areas where the terrestrial plants grow. What are the areas they grow? Plains, mountains, deserts, marshy areas, and heavy rainfall areas. Okay, we'll start with plants that grow in plains. Trees growing in plains such as Ashoka, Neem, Gulmohar, they have many branches. Okay, they have several branches. These are actually the characteristics of trees that grow on plains. And what's the next characteristic? That is, they shed their leaves during autumn season. Okay, what is autumn season? That season which comes after summer, when the leaves fall off completely from the trees, and this is the third season of the year. Okay, so they shed their leaves during autumn season, and again they bear new leaves during spring season. And what's a spring season? It's a season after winter and before summer, and it's the time when flowers bloom and trees begin to grow and reproduce. Okay, this is the spring season. So what it sheds leaves during autumn season, and again leaves grow during the spring season. And these trees, they are quite tall. Okay, the height is tall and dense on the top, that is thick on the top part. You can see the images of Ashoka, Neem and Gulmohar is given here. Okay, so they are dense and thick at the top part of the tree. Now one more thing, bamboo. Bamboo is the fastest growing woody plant in the world, and it grows 35 inches in a single day. So this might come in one word. Okay, remember, this is the fastest growing woody plant in the world is bamboo. So we have seen about plants growing in plains. Next we'll see plants that grow on mountains. Now in mountain area, you know it, the weather is usually cold in mountain areas, and there may be one snowfall. Okay, and trees which grow in such areas are like pine, fir, cedar. Okay, they grow in such areas and they have tall and straight trunk. Okay, the tree trunk is tall and straight. And they are cone-shaped. Why are they cone-shaped? Because it helps the snow to slide off easily. Now you see these trees are not cone-shaped. Okay, so if such trees grow in mountain areas, what happens if snow falls? They cannot, the snow will not slide off easily. It will remain back on the tree leaves, and then these trees will rot. But in case of pine trees, what happens? The snow can slide off easily. It's a bit triangular in shape also, right? The tree shape is triangular in shape. So the snow slides off easily. And leaves are needle shaped. Okay, they are needle like waxy leaves. Okay, waxy coating is slippery. Alright, and it allows the snow to shed off from them. Okay, and such leaves also, it ensure minimum loss of water. Now, needle-shaped leaves, what happen? The waxy coating, it helps to retain more water. Okay, that is, they stop the loss of water. And these are therefore known as coniferous trees or conifers. So, trees which grows in mountain region are known as conifers or coniferous trees. Okay, like needle shaped, right? What is needle shaped trees leaves look like? They have thick waxy coating that retain more water than regular leaf. Okay, that's the characteristic. And since they don't shed each they fall, they can capture sunlight for nearly the entire year. They do not shed off. The leaves do not shed off, and they capture sunlight for the entire year, and they can survive ice and snow. That's how this adaptation helps trees to survive in the mountain region. The plants grow in desert. What are the plants that grow in desert? And you know, desert area is very hot, dry. Okay, desert are vast areas of barren land. What is a barren land? It's an area where you cannot grow plants easily. Okay, so desert have the barren land, and they receive very little rainfall or no rainfall. Okay, so adaptation in desert plants, they ensure that they can acquire the most of water that is available to them. That is, they try to obtain the water whichever they get. Okay, the amount of water, whatever they get, they try to obtain it. And while at the same time, the loss of water is also minimum. Now, how they can retain water, this how they are able to survive. Like, for example, we take the cactus plant. Okay, now in cactus plant, what's the characteristics? The root of this cactus, it spreads below the ground to absorb rain water. Okay, so what it does, the root is spread under the ground, they spread around, okay, to absorb the rain water. These plants, then they store the water in their stem. Where do they store? They store the water they receive in the stem. And usually what they have thorns instead of leaves. They do not have leaves, they have thorns. Why? Because thorns, it do not evaporate water easily. Okay, it helps to retain water. Thus, loss of water is reduced. The thorns also, they protect the plant from animals that like to eat the juicy stem. So, like animals, they cannot approach the plant, okay, because of the thorns. That's how it protects itself also. And other desert plants like babool, kikar and date palm, they also have long roots that go deep under the ground in search of water. So this is the characteristic feature of desert plant, how it helps it to survive in the desert area. Next we'll see plants in the area with heavy rainfall. Okay, plants in the area of with heavy rainfall. Areas with heavy rainfall, they have hot and humid climate. Hot and humid climate is with excess of moisture in air. Okay, so trees growing in such areas, what they have? They have lot of leaves that remain green throughout the year. That means the leaves of those trees are green throughout the year, and that's why they are known as the evergreen trees. And they do not shed their leaves. Okay, these trees, evergreen trees, they do not shed their leaves. Instead, they remain green throughout the year. Example are like rubber trees and teak trees in swampy or marshy areas. Okay, so this is another area. Already I have explained you what is a swampy or marshy area. That is an area of land where water covers the ground for a longer period of time. That is a swampy or a marshy area. Okay, in such area what happens, the soil is clayey and sticky. That means clay in texture and it's very sticky. Okay, and the trees which grow there are known as mangroves. Okay, those type of trees which grow there are those mangrove trees. Alright, and the roots of these plants, they grow in the soil. Okay, roots of these plants, sorry, they grow up out of the soil. They do not grow inside the soil. They grow out of the soil. Why? Because they do not get any air for breathing. Thus, they grow out of the soil to get the air. And such roots are known as aerial roots or breathing roots. So, mangrove, the roots in mangrove trees, they that is known as aerial roots or breathing roots. Because those they get air above the soil. Okay, those roots, they grow above the soil to get their air, because they do not get air for breathing in the clayey soil. Thus, they grow out of the soil to receive the air. Next is your aquatic plants. Okay, what are aquatic plants? Those plants that grow in water are called aquatic plant. Before we have seen terrestrial plants. Terrestrial plants, they grow on the land. Aquatic plants, where they grow? They grow in the water. And there are three types of aquatic plant. What are they? Free floating plant, fixed plant and underwater plant. Okay, what are the three types? Free floating plant, fixed plant and underwater plants. First we will see is free floating plants. What are free floating plants? Okay, plants like water hyacinth, wulfica, pista, duckweed and water lettuce. These are examples of some free floating plants. Okay, and what are the characteristics? They freely float on the water surface. They float on the surface of the water. And these plants, they can float because they are light and small in size. Okay, they are light, that means light in weight, and they are very small in size. Thus, they can flow on the water surface. And their roots are fibrous. What are fibrous roots? Roots that are made up of many thread-like members or more or less of equal length. That's a bunch of roots. Okay, they are grown as a whole together. Okay, those are the fibrous roots. So these roots are fibrous. They have the roots, that is the fibrous roots. And they have fibrous roots, and are not fixed in the soil at the bottom. And since only the upper surface of the leaves are exposed to the sunlight, chlorophyll. Okay, the chlorophyll is present on the surface of the leaves. Okay, on the leaf surface, what happens? Chlorophyll is present and photosynthesis performs, okay, photosynthesis takes place on floating, photosynthesis is performed by this floating leaves. So photosynthesis takes place on the leaves. So we are done with the free floating plants. Next is the fixed plants. Okay, this is the second type of aquatic plants. Now plants like lotus, water lily, nymphaea, they have their roots fixed in the soil at the bottom of the lake or the pond. Okay, the roots are fixed to the bottom of the lakes or the pond where they are grown. The stems of these plants are long, hollow, light and flexible. Okay, hollow is like center. In the center of the stem is empty. Okay, so that is hollow stem. Alright, they are light and they are flexible, easy to move. Now these adaptations, they help the stem to bend easily in the direction of flow of water, means whichever the water flows, which direction the stems can bend easily and without breaking or getting uprooted. Without getting uprooted is coming out, okay, those plants coming out. Their beautiful flowers and large plate-like leaves float over the water. Okay, so they float, the flowers and the leaves, they float over the water. The waxy coating on the surface of the leaves prevent them from rotting. That is the waxy coating of the leaves, that such leaves, their surface is slippery. Okay, so this waxy coating prevents the leaf from rotting, and even the leaves provide nesting place for some tiny birds. That means some birds may come and sit on the leaf, feed on worms or whatever they bring the food, they sit on the leaves and eat. So it's a nesting place of birds also. Next type is underwater or submerged plants. Underwater or submerged plants. Now the characteristics of this is roots. Okay, the roots are fixed to the soil. Some examples are like hydrilla, tape grass, pondweed. Alright, so the roots are fixed in the soil for underwater or submerged plants. They're completely under the water. Okay, the plants are completely submerged under the water and the leaves are thin, ribbon like and narrow to allow water current to flow through them. That is the water speed, right? For the water to flow smoothly, this helps their thin leaves, okay, and their narrowness of the leaves, it helps the water to flow smoothly. They lack stomata. They do not have stomata. But how do they get the food? Okay, that is, they make food by absorbing carbon dioxide, which are given out by aquatic animals. That's how they make food. Okay, they do not have stomata, but still they get carbon dioxide from aquatic animals. And this activity even cleans water. Okay, it helps the water to be clean. This is the characteristics of underwater plants. So we have seen with the terrestrial plants and aquatic plants. Now we are going to see the other types of plants also. Till now we have learned about different varieties of green plants. Now let's learn about some unusual plants, that is the insectivorous plants. What is the speciality about this plant we will see? It will be interesting to know that there exist a few plants in the plant kingdom that eat insects. Okay, how they survive? They survive by eating insects, and these are known as the insectivorous plants. Now plants like pitcher plant and Venus flytrap, okay, these are the insectivorous plants. You can see the pictures here, the pitcher plant and Venus flytrap. Okay, so first we will see based on pitcher plant. The leaf of pitcher plant is modified into pitcher like structure. Pitcher like structure is a pot shape. Okay, you see the vase in your house where you keep the flowers, right? So that's the pot shape, right? So pitcher like structure whose walls produce sweet nectar. So the walls of those plants, the wall of the pitcher, it produces nectar. Now how it traps insects? The leaf tip is modified as a lid. So the tip of the leaf, here you can see, here, this one, this is the lid. Okay, so what happens? The leaf tip is modified as a lid of the of the pitcher. So when an insect enters inside the pitcher to feed on the nectar, the lid closes, trapping the inside it. Okay, so when the insect goes into the flower to suck the nectar, what it does, the lid closes, trapping the insect inside it. Juices are then secreted inside the pitcher to digest the insect. So after the juices are secreted, okay, inside the pitcher, and this digests the insect. This is how it feeds on insect. Next is your Venus flytrap. We will see the next type is Venus flytrap. The leaf of Venus flytrap is modified into two lobes lined with a nectar. Here you can see each they have two lobes. Okay, when an insect sits on the lobe, two parts of the sticky lobe close like a door, trapping the insect between it. So when it sits here on the lobe, the lobes will close, trapping the insect inside it. Now insectivorous plants, they grow in soil which is poor in nitrogen. Okay, where do they grow? They grow in soil which are poor in nitrogen, and these plants, they get their share of nitrogen by eating insects. So they grow in soil which has poor nitrogen, and how they survive by getting nitrogen? By eating the insects, they get the nitrogen and they survive out there. We have seen about the insectivorous plants. Now we are going to see about the non-green plants. Okay, we know that the green color of plants is due to the presence of green pigment called chlorophyll. Okay, the plants, they look green in color. Why? Because of the presence of chlorophyll. We also know that the green plants make their own food. Due to the presence of chlorophyll, plants make their own food. However, some plants are not green in color. So now there are some plants which are not green in color, but how do they survive? How do they get the food? Okay, they do not have chlorophyll to make food. So instead, what they do? They grow on other plants or dead animals or plants, or on stale food. Stale food is spoiled food. Okay, they grow on other plants or dead animals and plants or spoiled food, and they get their food from whatever they grow on. That's how they get their food. Like example, moles. They grow what? On stale bread. That is the spoiled bread. They grow on it. Mushroom, Indian pipe, coral root. These are some examples of non-green plants. Okay, these are some examples of non-green plants. They grow on other plants or dead animals or plants or stale food. They grow on them and they get the food from them. Okay, and that's how they survive. So we have seen the types of plants. Last topic of the lesson, we'll see how plants are useful. In what way are plants useful? Okay, first is they provide food to humans and animals. Okay, what they do? They provide food. We get food from plants like fruits, vegetables, oil, sugar, cereal, pulses, nuts, spices. These are all plant products. We get food from the plants. Tea, coffee, cocoa, beans. These also are obtained from the plants. So what's the first thing? First importance is we get food from the plants. Next, plants are used for making paper. Okay, the papers which we use on regular basis in our schools to write notes. Okay, all those we get from plants. Plant fibers like cotton and jute, they are used to make what? They are used to make clothes, carpets, sacks, roof. Okay, bamboo is used for what? It's used for making daily use, what we use at home, like brooms, baskets, chairs, mats, curtains, toys, huts. Okay, bamboo is used for that. Some plants from grass family, they are used even for preparing medicine. So these are the different uses of plants. And now students, we have come to the end of the lesson. I want you to go through the lesson once again so that it will be clear to you all. Thank you.